be fat as walking stick.
I remember when he got it. He didn't really need it to walk. He just wanted to carry it under his arm, shake it in the wind. That was a lovely stick. It was made of ash, I think. Varnished lovely with a little curve at the top for his hand. And a little rubber on the end, so it wouldn't wear away the bottom of it. And as the years went on, he carried it with him everywhere. And then he started to use it more to lean on, like a brother or a son. He'd stand and talk to you, and he'd have his two hands on his stick, looking off to the distance sometimes, but balancing himself with his two hands on his beautiful stick. I remember when he took it to the pub one night with him, and he got up after his pint, and he said, "I'm sorry, have anybody seen me stick?" And there it was against the wall where he had just left it. Then he looked at me and said, "You know, I don't really need the stick. I just carry it. It's like part of my dress, like my shoes and my socks and my well-ironed shirt." "Yeah," I said, "I know, Dad. I know you love the stick." And as the years went by, he passed on. And I went back to the old home, wondering what I could gather from my father's memory that I could bring back with me to the far-off land of America where I lived. I looked around, and there it was, up against the wall, his stick, my father's stick. I said to my mother, "Would it be okay if I took my father's stick with me back to America?" She said, "Of course it would be okay. I'm sure he would love you to have it." I brought it back to America, and I put it in the umbrella stand by the front door. I didn't use it, though. I just wanted to keep it there. So every time I walked out, I would think of my dad and his walking stick. Then one day, I said to my friends, "I have a stick that belonged to my dad. I think I'll carry it with me these days now." I went and got it from the umbrella stand where I had been waiting patiently for my strong hand to come and pick it back up again. I took it and I put it in my car, and I traveled with it everywhere I go. Not because I needed it, not because I leaned on it, but just like a piece of my clothes, like my shoes or my suit, or like my well-ironed shirt. It's a great thing to look at now and have it in my hands. Every time I go out the door, I feel my father's hand on the stick. And it brings back those great memories of yore with my dad and his walking stick.